This presentation is going to examine the concept of population size. At the moment of this recording, the world population is approaching 7.5 billion people, while that of the United States has, as you can see, surpassed 300 million. A population is defined as the number of individual elements within the aggregate. So that could be a population of humans, as we're focusing on primarily, or it could also be a population of dogs or of books. So individual elements is a broad term that can apply to a lot of different things. The notation in the field of demography is a capital P with a lowercase subscript that refers to a particular year. So the P with a subscript of 2010 is the population of 2010. And as we'll see, there's a great bit of variation in population as we go from one country to the next, all the way from the largest Asian giants of India and China down to the smallest island nations. When we study population size, it's important not to confuse it with the similar concepts of population density or population growth. Growth refers to a rate. Density has to do with the population per unit of distance. So some quick facts about population. We mentioned that the range in size from country to country is quite impressive. The smallest country is Antigua, coming in at 100,000. And the largest is China at 1.4 billion, although it's expected to be passed by India in the near future. Some other related statistics that will have implications for population size are infant mortality and urbanization. Now we see the infant mortality rate also ranges quite a bit, from a low of 0.9 in Iceland all the way up to 109 per 1,000 in Sierra Leone. The average for the world is 30.5 per 1,000. When we look at rates of urbanization, or levels of urbanization, I should say, we see that Uganda has the lowest. It's the most rural country, with only 15% of its population living in an urban area, while city-states like Guadeloupe and Kuwait have some of the highest rate levels of urbanization at 98%. The global average is 57. We can make some general observations about population size, such as the fact that larger nations also tend to be wealthier. They tend to be more urban, they tend to have lower infant mortality rates, and they also tend to have lower growth rates. They've sort of already gone through their growth, and that's why they're larger. Some of them are actually shrinking, as we'll see. But something that's another important observation is that the strength of a nation is not necessarily linked to the size of the nation. There are exceptions to the first bullet point there, some smaller countries with lots of economic wherewithal, for instance. For example, Qatar has a small population, but a lot of GDP, gross domestic product, that is. So it's a wealthy country with a small population. Historically, size and strength tended to be more closely related than it is currently the case. And that's because we live in an era of high technology, and there are many factors that can influence strength of nation. Size is also not very closely related to the quality of life. That again is going to have more to do with technology and levels of affluence, perhaps. But when we look below the level of countries, such as at regions, states, or counties, the size is strength thesis may in fact still apply. And we can see that when we examine table 2.6 and 2.7 within the textbook.